In this video, we'll take a look at contestable markets. We'll learn what they are, their characteristics, and the implications of operating in contestable markets. The theory of contestable markets was put forward by American economist William Baumol. Market structures focus on the actual competition in a market, and the theory of contestable markets suggests that the behavior of a firm is also shaped by potential competition. The characteristics of contestable markets are the following. In a perfectly contestable market, there are zero sunk costs and no exit and entry barriers. There is a threat of hit-and-run competition, which means new competitors can enter and exit the market easily. Also, there is a pool of potential entrants, which includes firms who are ready and willing to enter a market at the first sight of supernormal profits. There is no consumer loyalty, and perfect information exists. New and existing firms have access to all production processes and technologies. Due to all of this, firms operating in perfectly contestable markets will earn normal profits. So what does all of this mean to a firm? All of that actual and potential contestable pressure means firms will act as if they are in a highly competitive market. Here's a firm that operates in an imperfectly competitive market. Assume it has low contestability, which allows a firm to earn supernormal profits in the short run and potentially long run. That same firm in a highly contestable market would likely adopt limit pricing. This would result in normal profits and deter new entrants from entering the market. This pressure results in lower prices for consumers and a higher quantity of output. While this price is lower than P star, it is still not equal to marginal cost, and therefore, allocative efficiency is not achieved. This firm is also not achieving productive efficiency as it is not operating at the lowest point of its average cost curve. However, in perfectly contestable markets, firms will behave similarly to how they do in perfect competition. They will sell their products at a price that is equal to marginal cost and produce at the lowest average costs. In perfectly contestable markets, allocative and productive efficiency are more likely to be achieved. Bear in mind, though, that a perfectly contestable market exists in theory, but a real-world example is hard to find. The most commonly cited example in the study of economics is the budget airline industry. This is due to the relative ease of starting a budget airline and the implications it has for larger airlines. I'll put a link to an article about this in the video description. Governments may choose to make markets more contestable by deregulating an industry. This should decrease the barriers to entry to the industry and increase the level of actual and potential competition in the industry. In 1978, the passing of the airline deregulation law removed a lot of government restrictions on fares, routes, and the entry of new competitors. This had the effect of increasing the level of contestability in the American airline market. Today, fares are significantly cheaper in real terms than they were in the 1970s. This law played a role in the process. Hopefully, you've got a better understanding of contestable market theory and understand the implications of the degree of contestability on firms. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below or email me at enhancedtuition@gmail.com. That's us done for now, and I will see you in the next one.